Stefano speaking. Can you hear me?
Ireland looking to bounce back after that defeat against France at the weekend. by 42 points to 21. South Africa looking to go back-to-back after defeating England by 30 points to 22. Tie this one. Seeming it will be as inclusive and accessible as possible for all. That's why the team will observe just ahead of kickoff to acknowledge the importance of a zero tolerance policy to racism in any form of discrimination in our sport and wider society. Here's the anthems. First of all, Ireland.
Changes. Head coach Richie Murphy has made six changes to the starting 15 for the second tie, with Patrick Campbell, Sam Prendergast, Michael Maloney, George Haddon, Darwin Magan and George Shaw all coming into the side. Campbell has recovered from a thumb injury and he will start at fullback. His return means Dylan O'Grady will switch to the left wing, but Edgehill King, the scorer against France last Friday, will go on the right. Gibbons and Hawkshaw remain unchanged, and in the pack Haddon comes in the front row alongside McCormick and McSweeney. Coach Bafana and Lee Cole has kept the starting back line who did their duty in the win over England intact, the special pack for this tie. Reinhard Ludwig and Cameron Heacon are the only two players to get a second start for the forwards. Well, Heacon making six changes to the forwards combination who will run out Mavanga and Sibu Mbise. Props and Tian Langer and Hooker will pack down the front row. The new look replacements bench have only utility backs, Duncan Van Ludwig and Ahmad Khan, the 11 substitutes used in the opening.
Captain Green.
Benoit Brusilet is our man in the middle for this one. As we are underway here in Verona. Picked up by Covert of South Africa. This is Hartzenberg, who's testing the back line of Ireland already. And wins a line out inside the Irish 22 for this endeavour.
Green, for you. Number one, it's for you. No. Yeah.
Lang of Buttercombe Bulls from the line, and not the start he would be looking for. Picked up by James McCormick of Ireland. Time started to run, but they could be under pressure here and a little bit of trouble. Inside the long 22 with Gibbons. The Irish have a second bite of the cherry here. They have a chance to clear their lines should they wish to do so. And they will do with their fullback. Campbell, who sent it downfield for his one of his opposite numbers to chase. Gaff botted, chip forward. To put the number 10, Prendergast, under pressure. He spots an avenue and puts it into touch. So plenty of fans here at the stadium.
If I know it, it's okay.
At the pain and centre here in Verona. Play it down already. A match against France and England. An epic contest, must say. It lasted over 2 hours. Did have plenty of breaks, mind you, because of the heat here. So players need to take on plenty of water, plenty of fluids. So don't be surprised if our referee calls a 1 minute break. Around about the 15-minute mark and 30-minute mark.
Are you okay?
The welfare of the players is the utmost importance.
Wait.
No. Yeah. Benoit Rousseau will restart. As the sun sets here in Verona. And not straight. Much to the delight of the fans in green in the stand.
Captain.
It's going to be the first test of both backs.
Crush!
Penalty, South Africa.
Short line. Number 3, short line.
First test for the South African fly half. Tasha Nkomizulu, the South African captain.
Captain.
chance to open his account.
So, no change to the score. We're still at zip zip.
Hold back, please.
Long way to go. In this contest. Juggling that from Campbell, but he puts himself and collects and sends it back into touch, so another line out en route for team in white.
No meeting, please. Stay.
South Africa used his strength to borrow inside the Irish 22. Steyn. Hancock. Just a couple of metres out. South Africa smelling blood. Looking to draw first blood, and they may just do that. They're not far away from the Irish line. Steyn with a knock-on advantage. South Africans think they may have got the score here.
TMO.
I'm going to ask the TMO to see if he can find anything.
For me,
to see if Tian Lark has gone over.
The decision is prized. I see the grounding, but I just want to confirm if there is a double movement or not.
So our TMO check the ball.
The decision is try. Check a possible double movement.
This one.
Okay, Benoit, I have the decision.
Yeah.
There is no double movement. The ball is being grounded correctly on the line.
Okay, so try.
Try, Stan.
South Africa, draw first blood.
Thank you.
Tian Lang was getting the plaudits from his teammates. He's the man who got over the line. So 5 points to the good for the Springboks. Beautifully off the right-hand post by Engomizulu, and South Africa 7 clear. 7 minutes down. Penalty. on an opportunity to build a platform.
Handling wide.
James McCormick.
Stop.
Again there. Keep your
gap. Keep the gap. And come fast, please. Stay here. Come, please. Come.
Straight again.
Captain.
So minor trouble here for both sides.
That's right.
Front pass is half go. We'll have to put it.
Let's go. Crash! Mine! Use it! Stop! Stop!
South Africa. Send it downfield for Ireland to try and launch a counter attack of their own. Tackle there on Dylan O'Grady. Really up on the Irish, the pressure from the off here.
Back.
He's gone backwards, but they're in trouble. Relentless aggression from the South African defence. Penalty to Ireland.
Number 9.
10 minutes down. Stay in play, it does indeed. Forced over there from San Prendergast. And so after they capitalised on that, but out on the full, unfortunately, the number 10 comes Zulu. So Ireland with an attacking platform. Forced headers from both these sides. McCormick with it. Advantage being played. As McCormick continues to drive forward. Picked up by Maloney. Maloney chip forward. Irish chasing. But it's going to be picked up by Donovan Don. But back they'll come for an Irish penalty.
Captain, behind the mark. Here, the number 2 from the side. Here. Number 2 from the side.
Prendergast. Decided. By his captain's orders, that's taking all the dice at 5 meter line.
Okay, stay here. Please.
McCormick. Again, not straight. Well, he's very strict, our referee from France, Mr. Roussette.
Not straight.
So the hookers are going to have to be on their game today. A That's the third time that he's called that infringement.
Crash! Bye! Use it!
That's been wheeled. And South Africa will have the chance to clear. So no return there for Ireland. It's on the top Africa 22 in the sense that they're going to have to control the most of every opportunity they get here in Verona. He's sliced off the boot, so in fact our touch judge is galloping down towards the 22.
Yeah, please.
It's young and old, continue to watch here.
Back.
That's the try scorer with the ball in hand. Now let's see if this one's straight. Referee happy on this occasion. Gas from the crowd, but South Africa get the penalty.
Number two.
Tackler not rolling away. Just shy of the Irish 22.
Yeah. Not holding away. Number two.
All good, no problem.
Back, please.
This long is picked up by McCormick again. Lineouts have been left a lot to be desired so far in this game from both sides. This is Daniel Hawkshaw, who's got over the gain line, and more. He's won a penalty from it as well. They continue to go over the gain line. That will be back for a earlier infringement.
Number nine,
Nicole Stein was the judge to be the guilty party.
Number nine, not running away.
So this is the first water break of the half. So the players will just go to the side of the pitch to collect the water bottles to take on fluids. So just one score separating the team. Converted try from Tian Lang, 5 minutes in.
Okay.
Thatcher and Kumi Zulu with the extras to give the score on the corner of your screen. Ireland 0, South Africa 7 on this first water break. Party continuing in full swing here. Irish lineups. Finds his man. Maybe.
Sorry.
And referee got in our way there.
I touched the ball. Sorry.
So it will be green ball. So mind you, the Six Nations Summit series continues in the next couple of days.
Stefano, there is a blue band injuries. Can you check, please? Or the 14 green, please.
Have a look at 14 green.
Thursday. I'll check on something here. Tomorrow, Wales will play Georgia and Scotland v Italy. Whet your appetite. All these teams are back next week.
Clash.
On Tuesday, in fact, where
he
the French
was running into
the
space with two players in front.
Okay, it's a rugby collision or not?
Yeah, it's a rugby collision.
Okay. It's a rugby collision, so we stay. No rugby collision about the, for the demo, so. Okay.
What do you mean?
A clash. Demo check. That's good.
Front,
green. Sorry, boy.
Just checking the... Here we go. Okay. No, in fact, we're okay. We're okay, so we continue. Michael Maloney.
Crash!
With the putting.
Fine!
Only flex. Ireland up to the South African 22. Picked up by George Shaw. Ripped away from Cameron Henkel of South Africa. Going backwards from our referee. Picked up by Nell. Tackle then by McCormick of Ireland. Stain. Baines. South Africa, camped at the 22, Ireland put them under pressure, so they may have to go the ideal route. That's indeed the case from the left boot of Nico Stain. Out of play, so Ireland will restart, still inside the South African half.
He has had his ankle trapped by a player on the floor, but no problem.
Okay.
His injury.
There you go. You can hear from our TMO the reason for that injury. Kick here from Stain.
Yeah.
there is the penalty kick and both back.
Across the field is Adam McNamee of Armagh and Ulster. Stolen at the line out by South Africa. Now back in Irish possession. Knock on advantage, which they'll come back and play. Maloney with the put in picked up by Shaw. Prendergast. Ball knocked forward again, some handling headers from both sides this first quarter of the game. Stain. Gumzulu. James. Colfort. And Ireland with the penalty.
You're diving.
Get on the scoreboard here from inside South African 22. Comet goes long. He's not there again. He's lost a few at the line out. The Irish hooker. Charge down. Back to come for the.
Lina with D'Angelo Britton.
The Lynn Fentons is with 20 minutes down. And Ireland have.
Lina with D'Angelo.
Penalty on the 22 this time. But it's a good opportunity just to get a point on the board. So far they've come back. Visits to the Irish 22 with nothing to score from it, so I think it's the case now just to get some points on the board. Sam Prendergast of Lansdowne FC in Leinster decided to try and secure 3 points. Ireland on the board. Three points from the boots of Sam Prendergast. Has reduced the deficit to just 4. Ireland 3, South Africa 7. Away, Stain. South Africa cancel attack. This should be a second try. Oh, it's a loose pass. And maybe a knock forward.
Well, it was a 3-on-1 on that left wing. And they were odds on to score a second. But a loose pass has cost them dear. This really needs to be 12-3. Ethan James couldn't pick up from that low pass. Ball just died. South African 13. And another chance to clear. Shaw under pressure from the scrum half stain. Side, so
obstruction
in fact is the decision, and Ireland will be able to send this ball downfield. Prendergast right boot doesn't find touch. Cardinal Sin from the Irish number 10. South Africa with the counter attack. Springboks in midfield through Stain. Plenty advantage to come. A team in white, but they may not need it. Ethan James looking to try and redeem himself. This now nearly scoring a second. Try for South Africa. Gaps are beginning to open up. And the advantage is over now. Matter's left hand side. He's going to chip and chase instead for Stain. Stain for the second. Oh, what a tackle! What a top tackle that is from King. He's kept the score at 4 points. Ball still in play though. It hasn't gone dead. Mbeatse. Baines. Hancom. South Africa still sensing they could get a second here. Stain. Advantage coming the well. This is Lang looking for a second try. Staying again, they're bullying themselves over, and they are over this time. Reinhard Ludwig is the scorer. Well, Ireland seem to have got away with it with that superb tap tackle by Eitzel King. But South Africa regrouped. And Reinhard Ludwig of the Bulls.
All clear for me, Benoit.
Thanks.
For South Africa, a 12-3 lead.
Yes, it's here. As you want off the line.
This to go 11 clear. Hooked away, hooked away. So 9 the difference. Fendergast restarts. Ball has been collected just about by George Shaw. South Africa, crossfield kick. Try and put the Irish fullbacks under pressure.
On green! Stop! Stop!
Bobbling away for Colbert.
Back, no!
Now the game of kick and tennis continues between these two sides. Which team blinks first?
Stop!
In fact, it's a good kick in there from Colbert. Superb kick this was. The tap tackle off the kick. That is just outstanding. Last gasp tackle to save a certain second try, which South Africa do regroup and the last together. McCormick. Once again. If he had another hint the first time, the Irish number two, I think he's going to get it now.
It's clear.
I'm pretty sure the referee is right on this. This is never in a month of Sundays is that straight.
Crush!
Penalty advantage coming to South Africa. James, tackled by his opposite number, Gibbons. Don. South Africa seeking a third try. 10 minutes to go in this first half. Another advantage coming the way.
Release.
To the Junior Springboks.
No advantage. Healing.
Back they come. So options here for South Africa. They can really give themselves some clear daylight here.
10, number 3, please.
And so much so that the Irish team are going to get a tackle enough.
Captain, please. Three penalty kicks against this player.
Okay.
You must to improve your discipline, okay? Thanks. Yes, wait. What do you choose? What do you choose? Okay, so, and after, yes. Tell me. On the line.
5 meter line out for South Africa. Could be in big trouble here. Especially if they can find a third. Right, and there's still 9 minutes to go in this half, and they are going to find a third. Well, it's one-way traffic, and it's relentless. And it's a second try for Tian Lang.
Stefano, the ball is on the front in the second mode, so for me, it's good. And the ground game is good.
Relentless stuff from South Africa.
Try and have a look.
Yeah. After what?
17 points to 3. TMO's going to have a quick glance at this, but it looks good from the angles we've seen so far. The referee's right there. South Africa right now.
They're okay, Benoit.
Thanks.
Ball was in front.
Yeah.
Quite comfortable, so 19 points to 3 incoming. That is the case.
What down, Mike?
So another water break for both these sides. 16 points the difference. We've got 8 minutes to go in this first half. Two tries from the South Africa hooker. The first and the third from Tien Lang of the Bulls. And his teammate, Reinhard Ludwig, number 5, with the second try for South Africa. 4 points from the boot of Mungam's Zulu, the South Africa under-20s captain. Sam Prendergast of Ireland with the only score of note. Now it's a penalty from his right boot. So Ireland have it all to do as they take along a lot of water in this second water break. As we have, what's just it's over not a 7.5 minutes to go in this first half. Prendergast restarts. And to take it quickly, but stopped in their tracks. Under the pressure again, the team in green. Trying to finish the half here, the stronger of the two. Seen any more points and try and pick up a couple if they can from somewhere.
White, please. Back. Come.
Once again, Cormick not happening for the Irish hooker. South Africa. Maybe already seeking a bonus point. I'm going to hit half time. Another advantage coming their way. Chip and chase going quickly. Mark hold.
No advantage.
By King.
Seven offside.
But yeah. Ruben Crothers was adjudged to be offside. So it will be
seven
South
offside.
Africa. With the ball in hand inside the Irish 22.
Captain, please.
Run. Adopted for the scrub.
Okay. Quickly, please. The mark is here, please. Okay, let's go.
Show that graphic there of how.
Here.
Efforts the Irish defence about to make in the first 35 minutes. Stay, trips. But still collects. Henkong just shy of the line.
Advantage, offside.
Raal is over. And that's a bonus point for South Africa. Raal of the Sharks. With 4.5 minutes left to go. It's turning this first half into a parade for the Junior Springboks.
Benoit, all clear for me.
Three out of four for the South African captain from the tee. And with 3 minutes to go, South Africa have a firm grip on this tie. Not an advantage Ireland's way. They're going to come back for that advantage. As they will have to put in, try and pick up something to give them something to build on as we approach half time. So 2 minutes to go. So Ireland try to build on to something at the end of this half. Maloney. Josh Hanlon. Once again, ball's turned over in South Africa. They've been relentless in attack. And they win the penalty.
You are off me. You are off me. You must. Please. Stop. You must support your body health. I'm off. Leo.
TMO.
Stefano. In 1% yes. Potential full play.
Okay, number two, white. Are you at the screen?
Yeah, we are in front of the screen.
Can you see?
Yeah, the number two.
Yes, look at the action of number two that is joining from the side, direct contact to the legs of the green player. Can you see the action or?
Okay, yeah, I see.
So number you describe.
Would give about the leg of the green players. The dangerosity is low. For me, it's a penalty kick and a yellow card against the number two white.
Correct.
Yeah, agree.
I agree.
Okay, thanks.
Well, Tian Lang is going to spend the rest of this half in the bench.
Number two, captain.
Ireland will have an opportunity here to try and get some points as South Africa are going to be down to 14.
And you, yes, and you is diving on the knee of the player, so it's a yellow card.
Okay. So two tries for the South African number two, and now he's in the bin.
It's 15 metres, Stefano.
He he's on the 15.
So opportunity knocks here for Ireland to reduce the deficit. Give them time to build on, knowing that they'll have a man in the bin at the start of the second half. This time McCormick does find his man. And now the Irish are having a drive. And continuing to build on this as well. Continuing to bottle forward. Still going strong, now 5 metres out. Maloney. Ball turned over by South Africa. That's been knocked forward. So Ireland will have the put in. The dying embers of this first half. There goes the hooter.
Okay, let's go.
Someone knows it's now the last play of this first half.
Oh, yeah, a new hooker. Please, can I have a new hooker?
We're waiting for a South African hooker to come on the field. And here it comes, Vukuzela. Vukano Vukuzela.
Who go out, please? Number 7.
As Nell will go off the field momentarily. Big opportunity this for Ireland.
Crush! Bind! Set!
Shaw picks up. To find a gap. That avenue is closed, but it's still picked up.
Advantage for knock-on.
Another knock-on advantage coming Ireland's way.
No advantage, knock-on.
But that would be the end of the half. So?
There is knock-on, so advantage is finished.
So for South Africa, it's been pretty much job done in this first half. 4 tries, already picked up the bonus points. They're 23 points clear at the break. Ireland with it all to do, but they will start with an extra man to start the second half. At the break, Ireland 3, South Africa 26.
For me, it's not a picture for a red card.
Clean out.
after both sides return to the field. With Ireland with it all to do. They're the ones chasing.
Yes, Benoit, I can hear you.
Dario? Damian?
As the sun sets here in Verona.
You can go when you want, Benoit.
And with it could be Ireland's chances here in this Under 26 Nations Summer Series. They're 23 points down at half time. They do have a one-man advantage to start this half. And they'll win a knock-on advantage. They'll win a scrum. Right at the start of the half. So, first score, vitally important. You've got to feel for Ireland to climb this mountain. They've got to be the first ones on the scoreboard in the second half.
Crash! Bye! No.
Picked up by McLaughlin. Ball knocked forward by the Irish number 9, Maloney. And South Africa this time will not be putting.
Let's go.
Collects from the scrum. Zulu chips downfield. Taken by Campbell. Campbell inside him. And already up to the South African halfway. Running rugby coming here from the Irish, and it's working out for them. And they're still going strong. No offload there, though. But up to Sure, just shy of the 22, but a good tackle there from Donovan Don. But Ireland could be away here. McCormick, ball lost. And another missed opportunity for the team in green. They'll have a second bite with Jerry though, but they've got to do it from the deep. King. Gast, right boot. Into the heart of Kovalt.
Stop,
he spotted a gap and he's done well. Well, it's good running rugby from the Irish. George Patton just didn't have the offload there, and you sense the Irish could have been in the corner. Still 3 minutes for Tian Lang in the bin. And another loose line out, and another one that's not straight.
Okay. Yeah.
All right.
Crash! Bind!
Stain puts in.
Sir!
Irish penalty.
Not straight. Since the beginning, you are not straight.
There's your reason why. Prendergast sent this one downfield. Into the South African half, just about.
Okay, so saw my.
Are you please?
Back.
Collected by. Can I turn them? Hawkshaw. Loose pass by Maloney and another loose one, but it's on the bounce and it's beginning to work out for the Irish. This is King. King with the chip. King can collect. He can do. Can he go himself? Just going to ground. The offload is still good for Campbell.
He's good.
Ball turned over for South Africa. And they get to breathe again. King Justin couldn't keep his balance. A little tap tackle. Sent the Irish number 14 off his centre to gravity. But they pick up second prize here. They've got a line out deep inside the South African 22.
Substitution.
And now the substitution. The cavalry is coming onto the field. Still an Irish chance, still with McCormick. Mahoney. Ball pops up and South Africa will have a chance to clear this time. They have a knock-on advantage. The likelihood is they won't lose it.
Back, please. Back.
The box kick downfield.
Obstruction, so we come back here.
Obstruction indeed. Well, there you go.
They are in front of the kicker. Okay. And there is a clear. No, a long bite.
So, white ball. 7-8 metres out from the South African try line.
Let's go. Okay.
Yeah, South Africa be ready to go back to their full quota at 15.
Crash!
Stain puts in. Hold. Fires it downfield. Not out of play, so Campbell. Sends Dylan O'Grady off on a run over the halfway line. The Irish number 11 and Ireland win a penalty. Tap and go, why not? Andrew Mahoney gains some yards. That's a loose pass, but still with the team in green. Malone of Loughborough University. Picked up by Mangan. Nami. Chip forward and an opportunity here for Ireland to get on the board. Are they going to get on the scoreboard? Well, they needed the first score of this half and they've got it. Dylan O'Grady's over the line. And relatively simple conversion to come. It should reduce the arrears to 16.
You must to be unfit and keep out your body heat.
that was the earlier run from King. Nearly scored Ireland try in this half, but they've got over the line this time through Dylan O'Grady.
Well, good for me, Benoit.
Okay, thanks.
30 minutes to go, still plenty of time to get back in this game, and you never know, another try here for the Irish will give us our Atkins something to think about.
Institution. Which number, please?
16 the difference.
Five,
Ireland 10.
Nine,
so Africa 26. With the boot downfield. Kept in play. Coming Zulu. Hartzenberg. LaRue. Sneak out of play.
Okay.
So it's very important for the Irish to get the first score.
Not quick for
of the second half. They got it through Dylan O'Grady. Good vision from Pendergast to spot the gap. Grady full of running. Africa, do they have a response to try and just close the door once more on the Irish challenge?
Avante.
Ball knocked forward. Ireland put in. Well, it seems like South Africa making the mistakes in the second half. Number of handling errors so far. Again. So they're under pressure here, and they've been picked up. Well, not maybe knocked forward there. I think they've been spotted, in fact, by our touch judge.
Please.
The ball's gone out of play, so South Africa will have the line out. But this is good Irish endeavour in this second half. Really throwing caution to the wind and having a go, and why not?
I think
it's the same line. So far, it's good. Taken by Evans. That's a hit. Nell. Still kept in play, so another counter attack coming. Ireland slipping back into the South African half. Good tackle there from Vukozila. Pendergast. Gibbons. Penalty South Africa.
Go.
Once again, line on our straight.
Captain.
Our referee, Benoit Rousseau, has been
pretty
strict on that
front.
Distinct law of the game.
Don't put your arms in the air.
No expense given whatsoever.
Not straight.
So first job here for Ireland is to make sure this ball gets clear. Mahoney, Munster, with the putting at the scrum. Collected by McLaughlin and back to Mahoney. Penalties have to get. First job really there should have been to try and clear their lines.
Holding the ball.
And then look to go again, but.
Holding the ball.
So Africa wasting no time here.
It's here.
Straight into the corner once more this is going. And another break in play for a water break. But just one try in the second half so far, and that's come from Dylan O'Grady of Ireland. With the extra tacks added by Sam Prendergast to reduce the deficit to 16 points. Still have 24 minutes to go. The South African are trying to get back into this tie now. Score for Ireland, you never know. Stranger things have happened. We've seen it in the past, we've seen it many times before. We will continue to see them as well. But O'Grady started this uphill battle for Ireland to make it Ireland 10 to Africa 26. 24 minutes to go.
17. Yeah.
And here comes South Africa number 12. Banis just shy of the line. Advantage being played for South Africa. He says the fifth try is just coming any moment. There it is. And it is Luciano Vukozila, the scorer of South Africa's fifth try. And they've restored their half-time lead with a relatively similar conversion to come. South Africa 31, Ireland 10.
Yeah.
All good for me.
Thank you.
The captain scores once more, 4 from 5 from the tee on conversions today. 23 the difference. Restored the half-time lead. And we've still got a quarter of the game to go.
Thank you.
Penalty, South Africa. It's going your way, it's going your way.
Five green.
Josh Hanlon coming up to the field. For James McCormick. So I have to collect the line out. Now, more set up, looking to drive this deep into Irish territory. Just shy of the 22. Good tackle. Penalty Ireland.
Holding. Backwell.
Taken by McNamee. Chip and chase, why not? How's the bounce? It's been good for Hawkshaw. Still in Irish hands. Campbell up to the South African 22. Needs help from the cavalry. Gets it from O'Grady. Prendergast. Gap opening up for Mangan.
Not really easy now.
Penalty advantage to be played. So Ireland with a free ball here. Come into the heart of the South African 22. Crothers. Still in the second penalty being conceded now by South Africa. As Ireland continue to bottle themselves forward.
Advantage for offside, the long advantage.
Crothers. Good defence this from South Africa to keep the Irish at bay, but for how long? Mangan. 3 metres out. Army of bodies there. But the Irish just can't get over it. Oh, Mahoney so close. Metre out and still continuing. And another penalty being conceded. A referee maybe. Got to be careful here. Somebody could be going in the bin. Back they come. But and you sense a number of penalties conceded there that somebody could be in trouble.
Yeah, too many penalties. Fair advantage here, please. Improve your discipline. Okay. You speak about all? Yeah.
America.
Yeah.
That's what the Irish captain was asking. There was two penalties there in the red zone. So you argue.
Oh. Sorry. Injured.
So the injury, the Irish tried to catch the South African defence napping there. But our referee didn't spot the injury that was taking place behind him. So since we have this, still have this delay.
Wait. All is good. Wait.
Hanlon. Good tackle there on McLaughlin. But the Ireland has got over the third or fourth time of asking. And it's Michel who gets over. Oscar Michel. And Ireland. Two tries to the good in the second half. And with a relatively easy conversion to come, they get it back to 16. And once again, there's still time in this match. You never know. Another score from the Irish. It will give the Junior Springboks something to think about. So next score, you sense, okay, could be vital here.
Then that all clear for me.
Thanks.
Prendergast wasting no time. So Ireland 17, South Africa 33.
14!
Two tries to one in the second half. So the South African captain will restart. Goes deep into the Irish 22 and the bounce has caught a few off guard. Prendergast though was first to collect and was switched on for it. Ball stays in play though. South Africa launched the attack from inside their own half through Ethan James. LaRue. Conrad, one of the try scorers today for South Africa, finds his way into the Irish half and wins a penalty after the Irish turned it over.
Number four.
And they're going to go for posts. Scott Wilson on the field. And Shane McCarthy. Wide of the upright. So O'Grady will tap it down and we'll have a restart.
No. No.
As I mentioned, there's still time here, so Marner can find a score here of sorts. Prendergast with the restart. Bouncing ball. Picked up by the South African captain. Prendergast again, dances his merry way out of the 22, but ball's been intercepted by Hartzenberg. And South Africa can really put this game to bed now if they wished to do so. Ball out of touch and play.
Not clear and obvious.
And the lineups. 13 and a half minutes to go in this contest. An epic game we had earlier on in Verona between France and England. Four yellow cards, a red card. This disallowed tries. Missed penalty kicks. Some great flair, a lot of handling errors. Fun for the whole family in that first game. This has been more of a purist game of rugby from what we've seen.
It's good, it's good.
Major mistakes have seemed to have been from the line. The referee has been very strict on this interpretation of the law. That was straight on that occasion. Handlin.
Use it. No, no.
McLaughlin going to ground. Penalty Ireland. As the number five, Mangan's lost his shoes.
Handling.
During that particular drive?
No. For me, if player green, to go to the ground.
Time off, yeah? Time off?
No, no, go ground. Let's go, let's go.
Gas didn't seem to be too pleased with that particular effort of his kick.
On the line.
Didn't gain as many yards as he wished. And still, Irish ball is picked up. Won by Crothers at the line. McLaughlin. O'Mahony. O'Mahony. Prendergast.
It's back, it's back, it's back.
Juggling act from Mangan, but still collects. O'Mahony. High kick, back come for a earlier infringement. In fact, it's a penalty to South Africa.
Yeah.
Maybe that is the light being shut for this Irish comeback. Certainly needed to get something after that second try that they've scored. South Africa now with the line-out inside the Irish 22. We'll have to put the final nail in the coffin here.
What's up, Ray?
Von Ludwig of the Bulls enters the arena.
10 minutes.
As the players take another water break, it's with 16 points the difference and 10 minutes to go. Changes for South Africa. Ahmad Khan about to come onto the field.
Thanks. Stay here, please. Stay. Simon.
Not straight.
Not straight.
Didn't need me to tell you what call that was going to be.
Crash! Bye!
Picked up by Michel. Loose pass, but still in the hands of Shane McCarthy. With the attack stopped by an army of men in white. Prendergast looking for an option. He'll have to go himself. Now gaps begin to open up here for Ireland, and an opportunity is a begging. Does the crowd know about it? But the ball's been knocked forward, but still kept in the hands of McCarthy. O'Mahony, Prendergast. O'Mahony to his left-hand side. Uses Prendergast. Hawkshaw. Hanlon. Prendergast. Still there for McCarthy. Again, is it getting, when it's getting loose and scrappy, the gap's beginning to open up here. A lot of tired legs out there, especially in this heat. Now the Irish are up to the 22. Just short for O'Mahony, but Ireland only 10 metres out now. Campbell. Michel, who scored the second Irish try. Mahoney. Ball knocked forward. That'll be the end of that Irish onslaught.
One and three,
right? Well, it was scrappy, it was loose, it was entertaining. Okay. 7 minutes still to go. See a lot of tired legs out there, especially in this heat. It's still, what, 26, 27 degrees here right now. Very hot and humid night.
Are you okay?
So it will be the South Africans who will have to put it.
Yeah.
To look to try and clear their lines.
Knock on green. Put it on
right. Let's go. Are we winning?
Let's go,
try.
Let's go, try.
You're from this. Come on, come on.
Let's go, long. Crash. Bind. Dead. Use it. Yes.
Off the scrum picked up by Ningiza. This is Evans.
No.
That's what Africa want to do, a bit of running rugby themselves. That was locked on, so Irish put in inside the South African 22. Another opportunity for Ireland. Time now the enemy though.
Substitution,
10, 14, green, and 4. 6, 6 twice. Please, keep straight when you push. Straight.
So watch where you stand on the mark.
Okay. Andy.
Same one. No, 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 no.
Push.
Come on, Arsh.
Come on.
Second.
Push in.
This one open.
Open. Open. Come.
Crash.
I want more. Off space. Okay.
Mars?
Yes. I just want a big space.
Crash! Oh. Bind! Set! Use it!
Thank
you. Ball knocked forward again.
Advantage for Nocon. No advantage. You're diving.
So about to come for a South Africa put in this time.
As
we approach the dying embers of this tie. Five tries for South Africa. Very much heavy odds on now. They're going to take the victory here and head into their last group game against France. Two tries from Tion Lang. We also saw 10 minutes in the bin. In this tie, Cornfrahl and Reinhard Ludwig. And their only try this half has come from the replacement.
Malcolm Green.
Lucanio Vokozela.
Please, I tell both.
Credit to Ireland though, who are winning the half by 14 points to 7. The damage done in the first half. The building house from the South African team for the platform for what will be this victory. Fancy South Africa.
Engine. Clear engine. Time off.
Another player down.
Injured. Loose head. Rally clear. Let's go.
So 3.5 minutes left to go. Taken by Dylan O'Grady. Can the Irish get another score? Maybe potentially get a bit of a bonus point to try and get it within 7. Knocked forward. Another handling error. We've seen plenty of them so far in this tie.
Come right.
2.5 minutes left to go. One of the last replacements coming onto the field.
Yeah.
fact, it's the double try scorer, Tian Lang, returning. So near the roof of the balls. Put in and he will collect, just about collect. So can South Africa, looking for the coup de grace. Bente, advantage this time. Ireland will have the put in. Looking for a consolation score with 90 seconds to go.
That's why I'm looking my bike.
Keep it straight, please. Thanks.
So one last hurrah for this Irish side.
Crush!
Well, that'll eat up another 30 seconds, so we will be come last play.
Off pace, please. Off pace. Let's go.
Fresh! Fine! Set!
So O'Mahony with the last play of the game. Ireland looking for a consolation score. McCarthy. Kept in play. Good hands. But knock on advantage, and this will be the game. Next time the ball goes out of play, but instead, a merry dance up to the halfway line for Hartzenberg. South Africa knocked it forward.
No.
So Ireland with maybe one last chance. With a couple of players down as well. This could be the chance, the opportunity to get a third try. McCarthy into the 22. Numbers here on this left-hand side. South Africa down with 14 at the moment. Is there a player down injured? Cooper. McNamee. And this is Crothers. Crothers is going to score, and it is a consolation try for the Irish. Well, they haven't won the game, but they've definitely won the half. A very resolute performance from this Irish team in the second half. Scoring three tries, South Africa's won in the second half here. Showing everybody what they're all about. Extras to be added momentarily. One try shy of a bonus point, and going to be a couple of points shy of a bonus point as well.
Okay,
South Africa did the damage in the first half, in the first 30 minutes. Scored in four tries. Two from Tian Lang before he entered the bin. Kornral, Reinhard Ludwig in that first half. That first 30 minutes gave the South Africans a 26 points to 3 lead at the break. Ireland come back with that first score from Dylan O'Grady. Austin Michel also on the score sheet, and then Ruben Crothers late on. No doubt Ireland will be pleased with what they did in the second half. The damage was done in the first. South Africa will face France, could be in two wins from two. Ireland will go and face England, who won earlier today. It's been a very good day here in Verona. A very good day from South Africa. They have taken this under-16s, under-20s Summer Series Six Nations game by 33 points to 22. In fact, I'll correct that. It was 33 points to 24. Well done to Africa, who now go on to face France in their final game. Ireland will try and pick up a victory against England, who will be full of confidence after their victory earlier on today against France. Let's look at the pool. South Africa 2 from 2. They lead with 10 points. England with that win today, level with France on 6 points apiece. Ireland at the bottom of the group on 2 points. And they will return Tuesday. France will play South Africa, Ireland will play England. Thank you very much for your company here in Verona. See you soon.